interesting it is. Oh, why don't you pull it? Oh, so it is 4 dB. Saya sendiri yang paham. Yang terakhir. From this kit contact auto 100 Ultra Super. Very durable, very tiny. Canon Felix. Romo min ini por ini lens Romo LK LK ini. Konica 35 I suppose. This Canon Felix with Canon Booster, very low fat. I kind of want one, but a bit fiddly, if I'm honest. This is massive, this is fast size.
Kalau foto ini jangan sampai ketutupan flashnya. Megangnya jangan begitu. Takutnya flashnya kalau ketutup.
Iya, untuk fokusnya
Ini ada udah ada set tangannya, jadi klasik banget, jadi kayak mungkin ini dulu apa sih?
Bukan kecil, Apollo. Oh hey, that's right. Very well, first year. Good job. Oh my lord. Yes. Very well, it's Nikon F military thing. Very cool, very well, if you want. Very nice frame job though. The lens cap as well. Also in green. And this one as well. Nikon F3 T titanium. I've seen better days. Very nice. And this one. Behemoth, very heavy, very sturdy. It's uncommon, so this is Pentax Pascal. So this is basically a Pentax Pocmatic without light meter. It's uncommon. And front. This is Gosen Luna Pro SBC. Possibly not accurate, a bit jumpy. Spotlight, despite its size, but not on my hand, it's pretty big. Yeah, it's a bit jumpy. A bit uncommon, Popcorn Univac. It's a bit like Nikomat. This and that. Sounds and feels very similar to Nikomat. And this Taktika Super TL. Beaten up Canon new F1. Look at that. We take back for this one. Actually, Canon 1-1. This is Leopax. And I think this is Leopax F? I don't know. There's no name. Looks pretty cool. Canon 1-1. The Leica copy from Japan. This Canon 7.
M42 nggak ada? Lensa M42. 42 yang.
Been a while. I want Nikon. This is just heavy. Can you grab it? This Nikon F8, Aspas TN, Atomic TN. I think that's the best way. Taktika MTL3. Pentax SD with Pentax meter on top. Looks very pretty, beautiful. Can I want one? Yeah, can I want one for this? For my Pentax Super S2, but the only problem, my Super S2 doesn't have the slot for the light meter, so I want it, but it's not used. Yet another Nikonos. This one is Nikonos 3. The other version of Nikonos 5. Oh, this Canon VT. The trigger from Advance. Only phone battery. Phone is only battery that I've seen. Battery power 35. Here, the Leica. The Leica Dana. I don't know. I'm not a Leica guy, so. I'm sorry, I no idea.
Yeah, satu dua tiga
nih. This is Canon Flex RM. Very rare. Thank you.
Mon di misalnya paling RM dulu, RM baru.
Canon Flex RM. Terus disitu Canon Flex with 5 meter.
Oh, menarik. Sebelum di
ini problem.
Di
very
premier.
Premier.
itu, ini sephonic
8, Vivo 5 ya?
Sephonic kelas itu
ya,
ini box
yang OM ya? This.
Alright, hello viewers, I'm Louie and currently I am in a rest area in the toll road and I'm going to show you my findings from the film photography fair. Although these are mostly are just small accessories, but they're quite expensive and yeah, quite annoying if I'm honest. This is the body cap for my Canon FTB here, and oh, this Canon front cap is actually from my Minolta. Previously, my Minolta Hi-Matic 11 uses this front cap, which is not Minolta, obviously. the front cap for my Pentax S2 Super here. It's pretty, quite pretty, and it's made out of metal. See? And this one is a bit rare as well. So this is the clip-on cold shoe for my Pentax Super S2. So here are the clip, the clamp. So you put it on the ducktail of the viewfinder. This, and this is a film roll. And specifically, it's an Ilford XP2 Super 400. And initially, I wanted to get the Ilford Delta 400, but sadly, it was slightly expired, like just a few weeks ago. But I don't really want to risk it, so that's why I then chose this instead, which is expired on May 2025. It's quite a long time. So yeah, this particular film, Ilford, as you might know, for some people, is specializing in black and white film. But for this one specifically, instead you can process this using the C41 processing, which is usually for negative color films. So yeah, you may save some bucks with using this instead of using developing the black and white film with the normal black and white developing mechanism. I'm quite excited to see the results using this. The more important ones is this. So yeah, my Nikon F previously has a bit weird whining just after the shutter speed, the shutter release press, especially on the slower shutter speeds, it whines. And sadly, the technician couldn't fix this, so yeah, it still whines. And let's pick 1 second and. Yeah, as you might can hear, it still whines. So, half second. Yeah. They couldn't fix it, but at least they fixed the film counter here, which was a bit whack, out of place. At least I'm glad that the actual shutter speeds are still quite accurate. The timing is accurate, that's more important. Well, lastly, the Minolta Hi-Matic 11. This is the one I'm most proud of. So now it totally fixed. Previously the viewfinder was very hazy as hell. I almost couldn't see anything out of it. Yeah, usable. It was usable, but it was horrible. I swear to God, it was horrible. And also, it's clean, as you can see, probably, it's quite clean now. And the patch very visible now, which is absolutely joy to use. I'm so excited. And also, they also fixed the shutter because apparently sometimes the shutter got stuck, but now it's fine. And it feels very good. See? Yeah, it's very good. Really, really like the results now. And also, I finally got the landscape for my Minolta here. The matching one is this is very hard to find. Even this one has a bit crack in there. Maybe I need to glue it to some extent, but at least still intact. Yeah, those are my findings and the results from the Lowlight Bazaar in Jakarta. Yeah, maybe for this time I didn't got any interesting findings. But I actually got one, but it's a bit sketchy. It was questionable at best. So once I saw the Pentina, so that is a weird camera. So Pentina is an East German SLR, but it is leaf shutter SLR instead of the traditional Leica style focal plane shutter, which is more reliable. From what I saw, it sounded and feel not too bad, but despite considering the price, I have to think more about it. Because, you know, it's very rare. I never seen it before. And yeah, in general, SLR with leaf shutter isn't exactly reliable to begin with, so yeah. Maybe I'll consider it next time on. Thank you so much for watching and see you soon.